Today we will be talking about a topic which is very commonly encountered by a lot of gynecologists, that is polycystic ovaries. When we look at polycystic ovaries, every 1 in 10 patients or women who walk into our clinic have PCOS. So the trouble mainly with PCOS, in order to summarize, is it is difficult to find what exactly is the gonadotropin threshold or the FSH threshold. For some patients, it might be really high. For some patients, it might be really low. And the recruitable pool of follicles is also increased because more of them have the same level of FSH threshold. Stromal hyperplasia contributes to a larger than normal amounts of androgen production. So the microenvironment that is present in the ovary is more of androgenic milieu rather than an estrogenic milieu, which is required. Likewise, even the granulosa cell aromatase activity is also decreased. So the levels of androgens which are secreted, they're not being able to efficiently get converted into your estrogens. And last but not the least, the follicular response is initially very, very slow. It can be as slow that you can probably keep giving your medications or your gonadotropins for about 7 or even 14 days sometimes, and then you don't see any response. And then suddenly towards the end of it, you see that a lot of follicles are coming up. So this explosive response is also dangerous, because we will be talking about the complications of this kind of hyperstimulation that happens towards the end of the topic.